rid of it, all of them. I don't need to showcase boxes of them. Some of us need to get rid of some pictures. Some of us need to get rid of some gifts.
All right.
Some of us need to get rid of some text messages.
Lord, have
some
mercy.
Of us need to get rid of some of them Instagram pictures.
Lord,
some
have
of
mercy.
Us need to get rid of some of those cake followers. Some of us need to get rid of some stuff and count it all lost.
Yeah.
I don't need it. You know, you ain't gonna be able to deal with it. It's holding you back. But for the excellency and the knowledge of Christ Jesus, I want the knowledge of Christ. And it says, for whom I've suffered the loss of all things, and I count them dumb that I may win Christ.
Yeah.
Now, dumb. Dumb is what the dumb people say these days, and they don't keep it stacked with you. You know, they keep it stacked. That means 100%. That means real. Dumb is dogmas.
All right.
It's crap.
All right.
And you know what happens when a dog messes in the house, right? You got to pick it up. Pick it up, right?
Come on.
You got to put it in the sack.
All right.
And you got to throw it out, right? You got to throw it out. So what you need to do is some of the mess that you got at home, you need to take and pick it up, put it in the sack, and throw it out.
Yeah.
So whenever you get home tonight or on your phone and in the cycle thing, you need to pick up some stuff,
yeah,
put it in a sack,
yeah,
and throw it out.
Yeah.
That I may win Christ. That's what Paul was saying. That I may win Christ. So that this was some sort of allusion to an Olympic race. It was somewhat of an allusion to a race he was running. He was running to win Christ. In verse 9 it says,
yeah,
I be found in him, not having my own righteousness, which is of the law, that Pharisee law. No, 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 I don't want that no more. I don't need that no more. Not have my own righteousness. You see, Paul had his own righteousness. Everything Saul did was righteous. He had his own righteousness according to the law. But that which is through the faith of Christ, which is by the righteousness of God by faith. So I'm giving up my will for God. So I'm exchanging my stuff to take up the righteousness of God. The Bible says, let him hunger and thirst after righteousness.
Yeah.
Come forward, come get it. And that was Paul was simply saying, I've got to drop this other stuff to get the righteousness of God. And it says that I may know him and the power of his resurrection. So Paul says all of this as he was running. Because this was a race Paul was running to win Christ. He says that I may know him and the power of his resurrection.
Yeah!
I'm pretty sure Saul had heard about this Jesus, and I'm pretty sure he knew some about him. I'm pretty sure he heard about the events of the week that happened Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and early that Sunday. And Paul, well, then Saul probably thought, well, he ain't got nothing on me, but now that he's had a changed mind, he said, now I want to know in the resurrection. You know that power that he had got him up. I want that same power. How can I get that resurrection power? Some of this, us in this room, you should be asking God for that resurrection power. Resurrect my life, God. Resurrect my spirit. God, resurrect these dead bones in my house. God, I need some power. It says, in the power of his resurrection and in the fellowship of his suffering.
Yeah.
Some of us may be thinking, what in the world was Paul thinking about it in the fellowship of his suffering? I mean, you know, we want the power, but we don't want the suffering. But what Paul was saying is the same way that Jesus suffered, I might as well suffer the same way. Whatever it takes to get to him, whatever it takes to get to him, I've got to suffer just like he did. I'm willing to suffer in the fellowship of his suffering. It's just sometimes when people say we need to help each other,
yeah,
yes, we do. We do need to help each other when people are going through. Because people are going through. Yes, we do need to help each other. But sometimes, we just need to let people just go on through by themselves. Now, it's okay to pray for them. But be careful, we got praying for you too. But
yes.
Pray for them, and, you know, prayer time, your secret time. But don't try to, if anything, push them. Because if you're really trying to win Christ, then you got to be able to suffer with them yourself. So it's in the fellowship of his suffering. So it being made comfortable to us, that's the same way that he died and resurrected and ascended to heaven and that glorious body. That's the same thing I want to do. I want to resurrect. I want the resurrection power. I want to be conformed to that glorious body. I just want to be made like Christ. So then in verse 11, he says, that if by any means I may attain to the resurrection of the dead. If by any means whatever it takes. By any means, if you really want something, you got to work for it.
Amen.
And if you really, 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 really want it, you want to work overtime for it. That's why Paul was saying, by any means, that I may attain the resurrection of the dead. I want to get up to, and then he says, let me straighten it out. Not as though I had already attained, either were already perfect, but I follow after it that I may apprehend, therefore, which I have all apprehended of Christ Jesus. I ain't got there yet. I haven't reached the mark. I've gotten to the finish line. I'm not perfect. I still make mistakes. Sometimes Saul will creep up in my spirit, but I've got enough power and faith to tell Saul to get on and go somewhere. So what we've got to learn to do is know that we're not perfect. We haven't reached the finish line yet. We haven't reached our goal, but sometimes that old man will creep up in your spirit.
Yeah.
But we've got to tell that old man to get away from here.
Yeah.
But he says, I'm still following after him. I haven't reached it yet, but I'm still following after him. And in the following after, there's going to be some suffering, just like a race. There's some hurdles. There's going to be some things you got to jump over. There's going to be some obstacles you got to jump over. There's going to be some traps, some potholes you're going to have to jump over. Sometimes you might fall, but that's just part of the fellowship of his sufferings. But then it says, but I follow after that I may apprehend that for which I also am apprehended of Christ Jesus. Paul was saying the same way Christ caught a hold of me. That's the same way I want to catch a hold of them. The same way Christ first loved us, the Bible says we love him because he first loved us.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure we didn't choose God. God chose us.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure Saul wasn't looking for no Jesus. Saul wasn't looking for the Holy Ghost. Saul wasn't looking to be no saint. Paul was living life. Come on, talk to me somebody. He was content. He was sad he had it going on, and that's how our flesh is. Our flesh is content. It's our flesh thinks we got invaded. We got it going on. And Paul says, he came and found me. And the same way he apprehended me, I want him to apprehend you.
Yeah.
So in verse 13, I'm about to wrap it up. I count not myself to have apprehended. I haven't gotten it yet. I'm still running in the race. I'm still following after this. Paul said, I've gotten it yet. I've not reached the goal yet. But Paul said, I'm still looking for that day. And when I see Jesus, when I see the man that died for me, but I haven't got there yet. He says, I haven't apprehended, but this one thing I do. This one thing I do know. Many times people think it's a whole lot to be changed and be converted. Then people say it's a whole lot to receive Jesus into your heart. But Paul says one thing, this one thing I do is I forget about those things which are behind me.
I'm
reaching forward to the things which are before me. Paul said, I'm reaching for.
Therefore,
I've forgotten about that stuff behind me. I forgot about it because I counted lost. So no thing need to think about it. He says, no need to think about it. Forget about those things. Forget about all those old friends. Forget about those old people. All those things that used to keep me and hold me. Forgetting about even my flesh.
Yeah.
Which used to have control of me. Many times people say, forget you. Well, you've already been forgotten. Forget those things which are behind me. And as I close, he says, I'm reaching forward to those things which are ahead.
Yeah.
I press toward the mark, the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus.
Yeah.
Young people.
All right.
It took me about 25 years to finally get this. Finally understand that it's time to just give me Jesus. Forget about the other stuff and forget about all that the crazy stuff. Let me tell you a little bit about me. I don't even sugarcoat it. I stopped smoking when I was 17. I stopped. The legal age to start smoking is 18. I stopped when I was 17, all right, bud? I had an assigned seat and in school suspension.
My God.
An assigned seat. I knew there was 10 chairs in there. I even had a computer. It had no internet. But I had a computer at my table. I could play Tetris on. My teacher ordered back to send the stuff. That's how bad I was. And Jesus did a whole new system. So what I'm simply saying is, trust God. it's going to hurt. Because you got to understand, mama can't walk the walk for you.
Yeah.
Daddy can't walk the walk for you. Grandma can't walk the walk for you. Your pastor can't walk the walk for you. It's on you. You're responsible for your own self. And it's important. I understand there are a lot of things out here that are holding you back, a lot of things that get to your way, a lot of things that you don't go to, but you got to be separate. When people see you, they should see the Christ working through you.
Yeah.
So whatever you're going through, whatever you have going on, just give me Jesus. Forget about the rest of the mess. Forget about the clique that you're not in. Forget about the boy. Forget about the girl. Just give me Jesus. It's that simple. So I just want to leave you in that. Just, you don't hear anything. Just give me Jesus. You get frustrated in school, just give me Jesus. Friend don't treat you right, just give me Jesus. The people on the team don't like, just give me Jesus. I want to close with the A to Z of Jesus Christ. He's got you covered from the A to the Z. B, he is your best friend.
Yes.
C, he is your comforter.
Yes.
D, he is your deliverer.
Yes.
E, he's everlasting.
Yeah.
F, he's faithful.
Yes.
G, he's good.
Yes.
H, I like this one. I like this one. H, he's my hater regulator. Amen.
Yes.
I, he's immortal. J, he's a judge. K, he's the King of Kings. He's the Lord of Lords. L. M, he's my master. N, unlike everybody else, he never left me. O, he's omnipotent. P, when I sleep at night, he's my protector. When mama died, Q, he quieted the storm. R, he's my redeemer. S, he's my savior. T, I can tell him anything I want because he's trustworthy. U, when the rain of life is tumbling down on my head, he's my umbrella. V, he was a victim on Friday, but how many know, W, that he won early Sunday morning, amen. X, he's got x-ray vision. Y, his yoke is easy. Z, he'll zoom in and pick you up and turn your life around. But some of y'all might have thought I failed English class or something that didn't tell you about A. Do you want to know what A is?
Oh, yeah.
A is just this simple. I can't say it as loud as I want to, I'm about to lose my voice. But A just means that Jesus is all that.
Yeah.
All that.
Yeah.
And then some.
Yeah.
First Baptist Church. Just give me Jesus. Amen.
Let me show you how powerful the Holy Ghost is. And one man is shouting,